location a little north now into, from what we've been talking about all morning, Soviet Union. What, I'd like to hear your views.
All right, let's say right here.
Mr. President, the President of Togo. I'm delighted to
meet you. Well,
it's my pleasure. Prime Minister, Minister of Information, and Ambassador
of Australia.
So, Vice President, have a question.
President, it is a pleasure to meet you. I understand my wife met you when she was in Tokyo.
So, how am I representing
the How are you? Nice to see you again.
Concern in the United Nations and in the Security Council there for your position of support on the Korean airliner, on Chad, and these. Yes. I have to tell you, I've just been to a luncheon over in the state dining room in the region. Press people from broadcasting around the world, but there sure is a difference from those people from all over the country. And the rather cynical president, White House press corps. These people ask questions because they want news. They don't ask questions trying to catch it. But my table for lunch, I found myself totally surrounded by the opposite sex. And, they're all anchor women. One radio and all the rest TV, and they're relatively young, and finally went through the whole lunch and talking and exchanging views and everything. And finally, when I stood up to take some questions and answers from the whole group, well, one of them, very attractive young lady, stood up at my table, so I said, yeah. And she prefaced her question by saying she hadn't said this at all in the luncheon. My husband is a Marine captain. And she then wanted to ask some questions about where we were going. And she almost threw me there for a minute.
Mr. President, all I said was you need Ms. Reagan to join you in this one today. Yes. I want you to meet Greg Harkins, who is the chair maker, William Barham, his friend who came with us.
Responsible.
Yes, we've done business before.
That's right.
In this same way, there's one of these, only a single, sitting in our living room at the ranch.
Well, I tell you, the high point of the campaign was there at in Philadelphia when you sat down in the rocker and put Ms. Reagan on your knee. House.
Oh, they're saying at the Shelby County Fair that they have never given a rocking chair to anybody that wasn't elected president.
Well, look at this. Now, there is one thing about this, a double one. What if we both sit down on this one and we're rocking opposite directions?
Well, then you can do another one.
Can't do that.
You got to pull together, Mr. President.
This is a picture in view. But this.
Yep. Oh, yeah, that's great.
This is the most impressive picture, or is the most impressive picture I have. It's about 1,400 pounds to the bottom of each one's freight trucks. And it's a good quality piece of furniture. It's what America was built on.
Good just that one. Lord, look at that.
That's great. And that's exactly
the front end of an automobile sitting up there, or where the whole end of the automobile on four chairs.
I told one lady that I let all the air out of the tires, and that made 120 pounds lighter, and that's why I was able to stay up there. And she shook her head, yeah, and, you know, and left.
I've got one of his chairs there, and his whip saw was in the Capitol, too. See your friend Bob Hope, he got one even.
Bob Hope and George Burns in the chair now, so.
Well, I remember this day when we...
Could I get you to autograph this picture?
You sure could.
You got one, you can do that quick.
Get a pen that'll... Oh, for Lord's sakes, I got to start over again.
I'll keep that piece too.
I just realized I was writing on that.
Going to be a great success.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Well, I hope I can. I don't see the reason why not. Is that security?
We'll put you in a martyr on that.
It's good to see Nancy looking well. Please give her a hug.
So Lanny said, why don't you and I have a drink? first thing you know, he had Lanny looking for liquor. And finally, in his desperation, he told Lanny to go out in this other room and see if there was any out there, and Lanny just kept going.
He kept looking for the nearest bar. Thank you, Mr. Preston, well, so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are you?
Hi, Lanny. How are you doing?
So nice to see you. This is Laura Trout.
Hello there,
Jim Johnson.
Jim Johnson. Yeah, Laura is present. Very good to see you.
Laura, as you may know, won the International Award on the Science and Engineering Affairs Function.
And I'm honored to meet you because at 18 you received such an award. And how did you ever get interested in the thing that nodded for you? What did you mean, counting the rings? I understand it, the teeth of.
Well, essentially, I showed that you can identify fossil alligator teeth just with the tooth by studying the rings instead of having to have the entire jaw. which was necessary before, and the amino acids are more evident in the teeth than in a lot of other fossils, and that could lead to some pretty important changes in the fossil record in years to come, because now we'll be able to study the evolution of the animals in more depth.
Isn't that something? So, man,
can we just have one here also?
Thank you, sir.
And a souvenir, this is just a pin of the presidential crest.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you and congratulations. And I feel a lot better about your whole generation.
I have a message from the Notre Dame football team. They would like you to attend any one of the home games that you could, and they will get you 50-yard line tickets.
Oh, I'm disappointed. You're not asking me to play.
They could use you this year, and it goes around.
I would like to. I know that our security people have some difficulties about getting me out in the crowd that way.
And they know that you're very busy too, but they just wanted to offer.
Well, you please thank them and tell them that I'll hold that invitation in mind, even if it has to be sometime in the future.
Thank you all.
I used to broadcast. I mean, I actually broadcast Big Ten High, University of Iowa games, but when they have an open date, I was a sports announcer. I usually make sure that we got over and covered in Notre Dame.
Yeah, right.
So I've been there at the stadium. I've been I go back to being a fan of the Rodney days.
Oh. The Gifford. The Gifford.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I know the coach, he is here. I'm a great admirer of your coach there. And I hope that nobody, just because they lose a few games, I hope nobody thinks the change in the coach should be.
Well, there were some sentiments that earlier, I think, but we just defeated USC rather nicely.
I'll take care of that.
Spirits it up high again.
You know, there's a legend. Now, I haven't kept track the last few years. There's a legend that in the Notre Dame-USC game, the favorite never wins.
I don't know. I suppose USC must have been the favorite then.
It would have been in the California press.
That was a very good example. He used to be governor of California, so I don't know. I'm not sure that's what it was.
No, but I can remember before I ever was a Californian, in that great annual game, particularly back in the Rodney Day game, I was rooting for Notre Dame.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. Thank you so much.
In reptiles' teeth, you can determine from the rings of the teeth more accurate information than you get from the whole fossil remains, and therefore they can determine the age and the history of fossil remains just from examining a tooth or the teeth. You don't have to have the bone structure or anything with it.
It's amazing.
She's now a freshman at Notre Dame, and that's why the message from Notre Dame. I can't quite get used to girls saying they're freshmen at Notre Dame. 50th anniversary of the enactment of the Federal Credit Union Act.
Oh, Jay, how are you?
Hi, Jay.
Mr. President, nice to see you. Awfully nice of you under the circumstances to keep these appointments today.
Listen, Tom Washington.
President. These are all good credit union people that I have something to do with in the banking committee.
Jim Williams.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Mr. President, Joe Percasco.
Nice to meet you.
Mr.
President, John Hutchinson, Manchester, Connecticut, President of the National Association of Fellow Presidents. Appreciate you taking the time. It's a troubling time.
Mr. President, it's a real honor to meet you.
My honor.
Thank you.
David Ack, nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
See you.
Ms. Lasker.
Good to see you. Mr. President, Rogers.
Just had an author in here, the author of the book, Dallas, something about the city that he loves.
It's a great city.
Just presented me with a book.
Really?
Firm to wire, Mr. President. Continued your health.
Thank you.
Mr. President, Bill Donner, pleasure to meet you.
Merlin Lissett, you worked with you years and years ago here in Washington. Here in Berkeley. I don't know if you do work with your initiative.
Yes, that name is, yes.
Yes, but you wanted to extend your greetings to you.
Well, thank you very much.
Mr. President, can we do a group photo? I'll get you in the center and stand next to everybody.
Next to him because he looks so much younger than
I.
Okay, yeah.
You move back to the other side of the desk if you need to.
Thank you. Well, thank you. Well, I'm very pleased to have all of you. Jim, thank you for bringing
thank you,
50
brother.
Years
of
credit. That's a pretty good birthday.
I got a lot of money, too.
Well, the beauty of it is with other people. That's where
yes.
I told them coming in, seven kids and two houses, I was sorry, I had $13 in my credit. I wish I could.
But a good line of credit.
Yeah,
but your folks do seem to have confidence in the economy because they are beginning to borrow.
That's good to hear. That is good to hear. Well, I think they've got reason to. I think this is, unlike some of the quick fixes of the past, I think it's a real recovery. It's going to have its ups and downs. But the other day, there's a figure that I was amazed that the press paid very little attention to. And that was that we're today, already a fraction above 78% of industrial capacity is being used. Yeah. Now we've been clear down, I think, below half or something at the depths.
Well, the state of Rhode Island's got a few problems. They can help with
them. You can help us. We'd love it.
Thank you, Mr. President. Very much.
Thanks. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
Thank you.